Stir up the will of your faithful, we pray, O Lord, the striving more eagerly to bring your divine work to fruitful completion. They may receive in greater measure the healing remedies your kindness bestows. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Daniel. I, Daniel, have been seeing visions in the night. I saw that the four winds of heaven were stirring up the great sea. Four great beasts emerged from the sea, each different from the other. The first was like a lion with eagle's wings, and as I looked, its wings were torn off, and it was lifted from the ground and set standing on its feet like a man, and it was given a human heart. The second beast I saw was different, like a bear, raised up on one of its sides with three ribs in its mouth between its teeth. Up came the command, eat quantities of flesh. After this, I looked and saw another beast like a leopard and with four bird's wings on its flanks. It had four heads and power was given to it. Next, I saw another vision in the visions of the night. I saw a fourth beast, fearful, terrifying, very strong. It had great iron teeth and it ate, crushed and trampled underfoot what remained. It was different from the previous beast and had 10 horns. While I was looking at these horns, I saw another horn sprouting among them, a little one. Three of the original horns were pulled out by the roots to make way for it, and in its horn I saw eyes like human eyes and a mouth that was full of boasts. As I watched, thrones were set in place, and one of the great aged took his seat. His robe was white as snow, the hair of his head as pure as wool. His throne was a blaze of flames, its wheel were a burning fire. A stream of fire poured out, issuing from his presence. 1,000,000 waited on him, 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. A court was held, and the books were opened. The great things the horn was saying were still ringing in my ears. And as I watched, languages became his servants. His sovereignty is an eternal sovereignty, which shall never pass away, nor will his empire ever be destroyed. The word of the Lord. Our response to the psalmist. Give glory and eternal praise to him. Our response.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Mountains and hills, bless the Lord.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Everything that grows on the earth, bless the Lord.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Springs of water, bless the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Stand erect, hold your heads high, because your liberation is near at hand.
Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples a parable. Think of a fig tree, and indeed every tree. As soon as you see them bud,
if Father, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and religious, that as shepherd of the church, they may guide the church through prayer and supplication. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to serve one another in love.
For the leaders of our country, that they may strive to work for fair education, adequate jobs and safety and protection to all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to serve one another in love.
For our parish community, that each of us may grow to be generous in the growth of our SSCs by actively participating in all the cluster and community activities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to serve one another in love.
For all the sick and homebound.
Good. Let us ask from the Lord a very special favor.
We pray to the Lord.
So that we are able to go out of ourselves to help the other, to share what we can, to give out love, to give out a smile. When someone is in difficulty, just to go and speak out, to express our solidarity with them, express our love for them. May the Lord bless each one of us gathered here to go out of ourselves as the nature goes out of itself to do good to the other. May we, all of us, go out of ourselves for the greater glory of God. We make this prayer to you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Simple gifts we bring before the table of God. Simple gifts we offer as a present to God. They're the sign of our lives which now we give to you, O Lord. Please consecrate and make them good. Simple gifts we bring before the table. Want to sacrifice some food and grain to let the starving feed your love. Simple gifts we bring before the table of God. Simple gifts we offer as a present to God. There's a sign of our lives which now we give to you, O Lord. Please consecrate and make them good.
Pray, my dear brethren, that the sacrifice you and me offer here on this altar may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the sacred offerings which at your bidding we dedicate to your name, and in order that through these gifts we may become worthy of your love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your martyr, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ alone. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, holy God of hosts, glory fills the heavens to sing to him, Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes, bringing this great glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, sing to him, Hosanna.
As the bread and wine is transformed into his body and blood, let us offer our hearts to him, so that all our hearts may be transformed into his love, into his service. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Asking for the grace to be more and more altruistic, go out of our way to the other, let us pray the prayer taught by Jesus himself. Our Father,
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
As we offer the peace of Christ, let us look at the face of one another with a smiling face. Let us offer the peace of Christ. Peace be with you all.
Lamb of God,
who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, takes away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Behold him who is the expression of the love of the Father. Behold him who invites each one of us to go out of ourselves. Happy are we who are called to the supper of this Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The Holy Communion is only for the Catholics baptized in the Catholic Church. If there are people of other faith, we request you to remain seated and to take part in the singing.
Christ sharir sirf Christi bhai behno ke liye hai. Anya dharm ke jo bhai behn yahan upasthit hain, kripya apni jagah par baithe rahe aur gayan mein bhag le.
Thank you.
his inspiration, listen to his invitation, listen to the Spirit calling you. He's in the sound of the thunder, in the whisper of the breeze. He's in the might of the whirlwind, in the roaring of the sea. Listen, let your heart keep seeking. Listen, Spirit calling you. Listen to his inspiration. Listen to his invitation. Listen to the Spirit. Of children in the patter of the rain, your image cries of the suffering in the mourning and the pain. Listen, let your heart keep seeking. Listen to his constant speaking. Listen to the Spirit calling you. Listen to his inspiration. Listen to his invitation. Listen to the Spirit calling you.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us close our eyes for a while. Let us thank Jesus who has come into our hearts. What a wonderful thing it is to have our God within ourselves, to receive our Lord, to eat the flesh of Christ, eat the body of Christ. Christ has come into our hearts in the form of this communion. We have received the Lord in the Word. We have received the Lord in communion in this body. He has come into our hearts. He has made his dwelling in our hearts. Let us try to speak to him. What a wonderful God we have. Whenever we call him, whenever we need, he comes so close to us, to listen to us, to speak to us. In a moment of silence, let us thank God for all the wonders that we have, that he has done in our lives, for all the miracles he has worked in our lives, in our families. Let us thank those people who have gone out of their way to help us out.
how Christ has helped through them. Let us remember those people and let us thank God. Through the instrumentality of those good people, God has worked wonders in our lives in varied ways. And in a very special way, now He has made His dwelling in our hearts. Let us thank Him. Let us speak to Him. Our Jesus, the one who loves us, is within us. He came out of Himself to redeem each one of us from the pit of death, from the pit of sin. Now He inspires each one of us, being inside of us, to go out of ourselves to help out the other. Let us thank Jesus for this call that we have received from Him. Let us ask for a very special favor so that we are able to give ourselves completely in our SCC meetings, in our SCC activities. Let us ask the Lord to help us to love as He loved everyone. Let us ask Jesus for a grace to reach out to everyone as He reached out. Thanking Jesus, let us all sing, Jesus, what a wonder You are.
Jesus, what a wonder.
Jesus, what a wonder You are. Help me to be wonderful like You. Help me to be loving like You. Help me to be forgiving like You. Make my heart, Jesus, like unto Your heart. Make me love Jesus as You loved. Fill me with Your love so that I am able to love the other. Help me, Lord, to see Your presence in each and every person we meet in my day-to-day life.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that those to whom You give the joy of participating in divine mysteries may never be parted from You. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Novena prayer to Saint Joseph. Remember, O most amiable, most benevolent, most kind, and most merciful Father, Saint Joseph, that the great Saint Teresa assures us that she never had recourse to thy protection without obtaining relief. Animated with the same confidence, O dear Saint Joseph, we come unto thee, and groaning under the heavy burden of our many sins, we prostrate ourselves at thy feet. O most compassionate Father, do not be beseech thee, reject our poor and miserable prayers, but graciously grant and grant our petitions. Amen. Joseph, son of David, fear not to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. Pray for us, Holy Father Saint Joseph,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. We beseech you, O Lord,
that the merits of the spouse of your most holy mother
may avail on our behalf,
and that we may obtain by his intercession his graces which of ourselves
we cannot deserve.
We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Short announcements. Tomorrow being Saturday, we'll be having only one Mass in the evening at 5:30. Please pass this message to others. That will not be the as usual 5:15 and 6:30 Mass, but only one Mass in tomorrow evening at 5:30, followed by cultural program on the stage. So as we finish the final hymn, today also I invite every one of you to be gathering in the ground, whereby we encourage the children for telegames, followed by St. Joseph Church has a talent, or today we have dance competition from various zones. Please do come and encourage our participants. Let us celebrate and relax, and God bless. The final hymn.
Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Lift up the banner, let the anthem ring, to Christ our King. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. You are the words and the music. You are the song that I sing. You are the melody. You are the harmony. Praises to your name I bring. You are the mighty God. You are the Lord of lords. You are the King of kings. Now I return to you the song that you give to me. You are the song that I sing. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Lift up the banner, let the anthem ring, to Christ our King. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Along with your loving Son, bless, O Mary.